partnered by Adam Wong, who lives in Baraya Park, which is near Wagga. He enjoys sport and public speaking, is aiming to study arts and law at uni and become a foreign correspondent or a barrister. He'd really like to travel. Rebecca Atkins, our next debutante, is majorly interested in performing arts. In her future career, she really has no idea, but she'd like to do something to do with playing the trumpet, which she's very talented at. Another goal of hers is she'd like to sometime go to Africa. Her partner, James Beach, is also interested in performing and visual arts and hopes to find a career in these areas. He currently spends much of his time in those fields at Helston and hopes to travel overseas at the end of this year. Catherine comes from Naruma, and she assures me that this is a very hip place to come from. She enjoys netball, swimming, and really has no idea what career to pursue, but assures me she will succeed at anything. She'd like to spend a year as a tutor in England at some stage. Her partner, Craig Williams, enjoys all sports, especially rugby and touch, and he hopes to go to university and study and to travel. Is a Marudia on the south coast. Their interests include piano, skiing, soccer, and going to the beach. She'd like to pursue a career in science or something to do with animals. Carl Setter, her partner, lives in Wilton, enjoys squash and computers. Carl is the current editor of The Harvester, which is Helston Agricultural High School newspaper. When he leaves school, he wishes to study architecture at UTS. Sarah Gallard, her next step, lives on a farm near Taralga. Her interests include hockey, tennis, water skiing and swimming. Sarah aspires to be a sports psychologist and also to travel. Her partner, Rowan O'Hara, lives in Newcastle, enjoys rugby, tennis, cricket and music. He likes the beach and partying. He aims to go to uni, continue with rugby and generally enjoys life. Is Kylie Worthington. Kylie's lucky enough to live in Condobolin. She's interested in touch football, water skiing, line dancing and wearing cowboy boots. Once she finishes year 12, she'd like to take a year off and travel the top end of Australia. She'd like a career, something to do with the land. Her partner is Nick Waters. Nick lives in Narrabri and is interested in rugby, tennis and horse riding. He'd like to go to uni and study ag science. And we'd like to see as much of Australia as possible. Just getting now set up for the devs to present their dance. Very nervous, but they practice very hard.
much to all those parents and sorted others, and a good job by all the debutantes and partners to text them all so well. I'd like to invite now to the microphone our guest of honour, Mr. Robert Hindmarsh, to officially open the ball.
Partners, their parents. I would like to officially open debutant ball for 1995 and just say how glamorous the debutants and their partners are tonight and how much of an honour it has been for me to be able to open this occasion. And I think it's also a tribute to the organisers of this occasion and the school and the community that represents the school to enable these occasions to occur, where young adults can make formal entry into society that represents everything that is positive and that part, I think, of society that really can't be lost and overlooked. So congratulations to all of those that participated tonight. I know it takes hours of work and the preparation and the practice, and I hope it's something that you will truly remember. And once again to all of you, my congratulations, and I declare this occasion open.
Thanks, Mr. Hindmarsh. I'd like to ask Mr. Michael Kidd up to the microphone now to officially welcome everyone and say just a few words.
Mr. Robert Hart, Hindmarsh, Mr. and Sharon, Mr. Tony Wilkins and Daphne, Mr. John Toomey, his wife Margaret, Mr. Dennis Simon, his wife Robin, Debs and your partners, family and friends. On behalf of Robin and I, it is my great pleasure tonight to welcome you as host and hostess to our debutante ball. I don't think there's any greater feeling we can have than pride. And certainly tonight, it is a night of pride. I often speak of the achievements of Hurlston students and the pride they give us, but I don't think there's anything they do that gives us more pride than the accolades we so often get about their personal qualities. Hurlston students are seen as having that bit extra, that touch of class, and certainly I think we're seeing